Hello and welcome to another Zach Carnage video. So I did promise that I'd give you a look at the new broadside. So here it is. I'll just get you an old broadside for size comparison. So here's another one. They're almost the same height actually. Well, the head is not. The head's quite a bit lower, higher up on the new one. But the with the rail guns, it's almost the same height with that target lock on. So yeah, that's the size comparison. New one's a lot bulkier. And I did say that I'd be magnetising mine, so I can take off these twin link plasma rifles. Got a magnet in there and one on the shoulder pad. I was thinking about having these turnable, but they kept popping off, so I didn't bother. And then we've got the smart missile system, which goes on like that. And this side we've got a target lock or something like that, which also comes off. And I can have the missile on there, like that. So I tried to angle it so that it looked alright with both of them. If I want, I can actually swap them around, so in this case I might have the twin link plasma rifles on this side and then put the missile on that side so it's more over the shoulder. But it gives me a lot of options, and I haven't just done that. Oh no, I've also magnetized the twin linked heavy rail rifle. So got some green stuff in each of the shoulder pads and some tiny magnets. These are the ones I'm using. 2x1mm magnets from Spider Magnets. And got magnets in the shoulders, so this goes on like that. This wall here helps to keep the 20 heavy rail rifle up because it's really heavy. As the name suggests, then the high yield missile pod systems can just go, if I can put it on. Goes on like that. So you know, it looks alright in terms of posing. It looks okay. But the main thing was that I could actually swap all of the things out. So this is the way I'm planning on running it, with the missile pods. And if you want more information on how I magnetize my stuff, leave a comment down below and I will get a video up actually showing you some magnetization stuff, because I've really got into it now. I've not just done that on my broadside, but also I've got two crisis suits which I painted a long time ago. You may have seen them in some videos, and I clipped the weapons off and I started repainting them, and I've got magnets in them, so I can put on different weapon loadouts on these two guys, and field them pretty much however I want. I've got quite a few weapons but magnetized already, did last night. So having a lot of fun with just like fiddling around and fixing up different weapon options for these two. So I'm probably going to run them fire knife, so get rid of all of those and give them plasma rifles and missile pods. Or if I want to run death rain, I've got plenty of missile pods to work with. So yeah, that's what I've been up to recently. And I've started painting my fire warriors again, so I got my fire blade built up. Glue still setting on him, but that's what he looks like. You don't have to use the cape if you don't want to. I know some people don't like that, so you can take the cape off if it's annoying you. And thanks for watching this video showing off my new broadside. If you've got any suggestions, ideas, if you liked this, don't forget to like, and anything else you can leave as a comment. And I haven't forgotten you subscribers. I've recently got over 300 subscribers, which is incredible. So I'm going to have to hold some sort of competition soon. And in the meantime, I'll see you guys in the next video.